नमस्ते ऑल ऑफ यू। माय नेम इज तरुण कुमावत। आई एम वर्किंग एज एन असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन फैकल्टी ऑफ एजुकेशन एंड मेथडोलॉजी इन ज्योति विद्यापीठ वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी अजमेर रोड जयपुर। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न यूनिक्स एंड शेल एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन एंड द सेशन नेम इज बेसिक यूनिक्स कमांड that everyone should know, even if you have a Mac operating system. So now let's go to the basic commands. The first command is pwd command. The first command is pwd command. Pwd commands means where am I? PWD is full form is present working directory. Present working directory means if we want to know where am I working, then we can use PWD command that prints the name of current working directory. Current working directory is the default directory or folder where the shell program will look first for the program files, etc. And it is where you are in Unix space. So pwd command prints the name of current working directory where you are working now. The next command is, before we go to the next command, we are going to learn what is a directory. If you are seeing the example here, slash home, slash yearning, and slash whatever, the slash home, your name, and whatever is the directory name. Directories are the places where you put your files and the contents. They are represented as word connected by the backslash. We can represent directories that are words connected by the backslash character. In Windows, they use a forward slash just to be different. On Mac, they are called folders. And whatever you do not put the spaces in directories. The next command we are going to know is ls command. What have we here? Ls command is a list command that lists contents of the current working directory. If you want to know the contents of the current working directory that are files and directories, then we can use ls command. There are some options with ls commands. The first option is ls minus l, means long listing. Long listing means if you want to know the details of the files and directories like dates, owners, permissions, we can use ls minus l or long listing command. There are three types of permissions: read, write, and execute. Read means you can only read, write means you can read or write, and execute means you can execute that file or script. If you want to know the details of a current file or directory, but in sorted by time, then you can use ls minus lrt command. And ls minus lrt command is again used with directories. Then slash home, slash your name, slash something is directories names and connected by the backslash. And you can use ls minus lrt and directory name. Next command is cd command. Cd command means change directory. If you want to change your current working directory, then you can use cd command. The example is cd slash tmp slash your name, where tmp and your name is the directory. Tmp we can say is a temporary directory. If you want to go your previous current working directory, then you can use cd space minus, that will go back to where you were just. If you want to go the home directory, then you can use simple cd command with no arguments, and home is the directory where your login starts. Next command is mkdir. Mkdir command means make directory. If you want to make a new directory or create a new directory, you can use mkdir command. The syntax is mkdir and directory name. It will make a new directory. If you want to go this directory that you were make, then you can use cd command, go there and check it by ls command. Man command. How do I get help? You can get help with the man command. Man command displays the manual for the given program or file or command, different command. The examples are man ls, see manual for ls command. If you want to see the manual for ls command, then you can use ls man ls command. If you want to learn about C shell, then you can type man tcsh, that will give the manual for C shell. If you want to learn other shell, then you can use man bash command. Bash means base command, base command. And if you want to read the manual for the manual command, then you can use manual man and space man command. Next command is mv command. Mv command means move command or rename a file. Move or rename a file means if you want to rename a text file or directory name, then you can use mv command. Mv command example is mv stupid.name.txt space bettername.txt. It will rename stupid name.txt file into bettername.txt file. That change name of a file that is given in mv command. Next is copy. Copy command is cp command. Cp command copy a file. This is just like mv, except it does not delete the original. Cp stupid name dot txt space pattern name dot txt. Cp command change name but keep original file name also. Rm stupid name dot txt. Now this is same as mv. Rm is remove file. Now next command is chmod command. Chmod command is used to change the permission of a file. There are some permissions which is given to each file or directories that are read, write and execute. Read, write, execute means if we give the permission only read, then we can only read it. If we give the permission of read and write, then we can read that file contents and write also. If we give the permission read, write and execute, then we can do read, write and execute that commands or that particular script or program. So there are some basic examples which is given in the slide. Chmod a plus r file name dot txt, make it so everyone can read it. Chmod u plus rwx file name, make it you can read, write and execute it. And last is with the directory name, chmod minus r u plus rw, make it so you can read and write everything under a directory. Okay, next command is rm command. Rm command is used to remove a file forever. There is no thrash and undelete in Unix. there is no recycle bin in Unix operating system. So if you want to remove a file forever or directory forever, you can use rm command. The rm command works like an example is rm unwanted underscore file dot txt, delete file with that name. If you want to remove forcefully any directory or everything, you can write rm minus rf slash tmp slash your name slash st. It will forcefully remove everything in your temporary file. Next command is more. Display the content of a text file page by page. More command is used to display the content of a text file page by page. If a file or text file is more larger than we can use more command to display the content of text file page by page. The syntax is more and file name display the content. Less is a replacement for more command called less, which is nicer search features. Next command is gunzip. Gunzip is used for file compression and decompression. If you write gunzip and slash download slash whatever dot tar dot gz file com with the extension of dot tar dot gz, it will decompress the file or directory. If we write gzip and dot tar, it will compress and create a new file with gz extension. Next command is find. If you want to search through directories, find files in a current working directories or other working directories, you can use find. The example is find dot slash minus name and file name. It will look at everything under current working directory with name starting with important and ending in the .txt format. Find slash minus name important.txt. It will always find it, but takes a very long time. Next command is df and du. If you want to know about the disk space and how much space is left on disk, then df command is useful for us. It will check how much space is left on disk. Df looks at the space left of all disks. If you want to look at space left on all disks, you can use df command. Df space dot look at space in the current working directory. And the last, if you want to look du space, if you want to know how much space taken by all files and directory, then we can use du minus sk dot and sort minus g. It will sort according to all files name or directories. If you want to know why my CPU and memory is very slow, then you can use ps and top command. Top command or ps command looks for the program that may be eating up CPU or memory. Top command lists processes in order to CPU uses, and job command lists processes running in the background of current terminal. PS command is also used for list job belonging to your account in order of what spawn what. Next command is kill command. If you want to stop jobs that are running in the background, that we can use kill command. Kill command stops all jobs that are running in the background. There are some different types of kill commands. Example, first example is kill percentage one. It will kill job first job as listed in the jobs. Second example is kill 1234. Kill job listed as 1234 by ps or tops. It will kill job listed as 1234 by ps or top. Third example is, if we don't know what is the suggestion, then we can use kill minus 9 1234 that was not a suggestion. And last is kill, minus 9, minus G, 1, 2, 3, 4. Seriously, kill all the jobs and the program that launch it. Means it will seriously kill that job and the program that launch it. Listed as 1, 2, 3, 4. So, the students, these are the basics of Unix commands, and you can use these commands in your Unix operating system. Practice it, and thank you very much for this session. I am now going to leave this session. Thank you. Namaste. Have a nice day.